Praise be to you and peace from God our Creator, Redeemer, and life-giving Spirit.
Amen.
Well, John the Baptist must have been quite the sight, but probably not somebody you would invite over for a dinner today at the church. You see, the camel's hair coat that he wore was nothing like these gorgeous camel hair suit jackets and coats that I've seen Bob Peterson and Bob Cook wear. Those coats are really nice and soft and warm and very rich looking. I'm guessing that John's camel hair coat looked more like it came from the camel on that Geico commercial.
He wasn't going to be co-opted.
religion that preached the law of God but didn't expect any change. Any change in the human heart or any change in behavior. So he went out to the wilderness, an outsider preaching on the margin of society to a marginalized people. He preached and he baptized. Now Jesus' introduction in Mark's gospel is similar to John. There's no hoopla about Mark's description of Jesus' baptism. There's no pondering or theological questioning about why Jesus needed to be baptized like there is in Matthew's gospel. Mark cuts to the chase. In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. Period. End of discussion. Or, beginning of story. The story of God entering into human history. The story of God coming down and being with people in the flesh so that God could take on and understand and live everything that we human beings live. God coming down into the water and up into our lives, probing and pushing and prodding us to pay attention. That's what makes me marvel so much at marriages that last.